The Strangers, Pray at Night, is the sequel to the 2008 hit film called The Strangers. And it takes place, we don't know how long after, to be honest, of the events of the first film, but it's a sequel to the first film. And it stars Christina Hendrickson, Bailey Madison, and the other two people in the family. We don't really know the actors' names. I haven't really seen them in anything, to be honest. And this family goes to this camp area where they're expecting to see their uncle, and lo and behold, it's not their uncle that they see, it's the strangers who then terrorize this family. Yep, that's it. That's the film. And a pace homage to a lot of horror films. That's both a strength and a downfall of this film, because when watching this film, you can't help but think in your mind, I've seen this done 1,000 times, I can't help but think, this is pretty stupid with some of the stuff that these characters are doing. They're just doing it because the scriptwriter's telling them to do. But I will say that I did like Christina Hendrickson and Bailey Madison in their characters. I thought that they didn't do anything special, but like it helps with getting the film, like, you know, watched. When I say that, I mean like it's the type of thing where it helps to have eye candy when the rest of the film is just awful. Especially given that and the music choices are probably the only positives I can personally think of. Because the music choices, what they do is, it's just so outlandish that you can't help but just enjoy their music choices. They're trying so hard to cash in on the whole 80s vibe that everyone is trying to cash in since Stranger Things did it. And this film is no different. It's trying to do that, and it's just hilarious with how they're shoehorning it in. And you can't help but laugh, but at the same time, it's good songs that they're using, so it's like, yeah, okay, I'll give it a pass. But, guys, I mean, this film, if you haven't been able to figure it out by now, it's pretty bad. Storytelling-wise, I would say it borrows a lot from the Friday the 13th films. Definitely the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. I mean, there's a couple scenes in this film that literally are straight out of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. I mean, especially like the very end of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Yeah, it's very obvious. And I mean, you know, you could argue, oh, they're paying homage, but at the same time, it was kind of like jarring, where it was like, I don't know, it just kind of felt like out of place a bit. This film, again, it has characters doing stupid things. The film isn't scary at all. I wasn't terrified at all. The pacing is also a bit, lanky. Like, there are some scenes that are going for a breakneck pace, but then there are a lot of other scenes that just take its time, and they try to be organic, but the problem is, it feels more amateurish than anything. When I mean that, I mean, the director didn't seem like he knew what he was doing. Like, it seems like he might have had a vision, but he wasn't able to put it on the screen, because what's on the screen, it's a mess. And it's a shame, too, because based on the trailer, I was like, this might be a fun time. Like, I'm not expecting it to be great, but it might be a fun time. But with poor storytelling, characters doing stupid things that really aren't developed, and just a weird kind of pace that isn't weird in an artsy sense, it's just weird in a, oh, I don't know how to edit a film sense. This film just really was not well made, and it wasn't really entertaining either, so I'll be giving The Strangers, Pray at Night a 1.5 out of 5-star rating. Guys, what did you think of The Strangers, Pray at Night? I will say this, it was better than the first, even though it's not saying much, because I really didn't like the first one. But what did you guys think of it? And let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And as always, guys, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and notification bell.